What's up, you guys, and welcome back to Last Human's Garage. This is what's looking like the vinyl roof wrap episode. Well, no, series, I'll say. This is only part one. So we've already gone through the whole roof wrap dream. You already know about it. We're gonna try wrapping that square. So let me get to the other details. First off, I have two vinyls. I have one now and one's on the way. I have 3M now. My Avery Dennison's on the way. Why did I get two? Well, the 3M came a lot quicker, and it's sort of like my practice vinyl. Yeah, $60 practice vinyl. But if this vinyl goes great, it is 3M. I was wondering, it says Vivid, but the sticker is 3M, and it has 3M backing, so it is 3M. And 3M is not as pliable or air release friendlyable as the Avery. So I'm gonna see if I can get a perfect install or not. I may rip it off. It's practice. And I'll be using the, I can't open that drawer. Some razor tape and figuring out my lines. I mean, basically, get my screen up. Basically, I'm just gonna, in the divot, I'm not gonna like go over and try and like match it to that or anything. I'm just going full. That's how it should be. Cause the bottom here is black in the sunroof, see? If I match this to this line, this side will be white, where this one fills properly, it doesn't have to go over. So I have to bring my vinyl all the way to the edge to fill that gap all the way back. On the spoiler here, I wonder if that is just wax. I've always seen like a little worn paint on it and stuff, but that one right there might just be some leftover wax or something, or it might just be the paint. I mean, I bought this spoiler used, remember? Let me just see. It doesn't look like wax. It's not really coming up. I think it is the paint, but no, I'm not worried about it. I'm gonna throw vinyl wrap on this crap. I'm just gonna, this car is becoming like very, very used, very enjoyed. I'm just beating on it all the time. Still working on my side molding project. So I've been running Road Warrior style, which I like. A lot of people probably think I'm like poor or something, but I don't care. I think it looks cool. While my gloss painted cherry moldings await their Spray Max 2K Clear Glamour 3680061, the best clear coat in the world, going on those. Why have I not done it? Because I'm waiting for my freaking vinyls for my front emblem. That's just dust that I can easily wipe off. But that's why I have it wrapped, to try and not get it all wrecked by the time I'm ready to install it. I'm waiting for my vinyl to finish this piece, then I'll pop my clear, which is only good for 48 hours once you pop it and mix it with the hardener. Super good quality clear. And there was one of, oh, and I'm also gonna clear my two flaps that are super gloss black cherry now, with the same super clear. It'll look so fantastic. And those are going back on too. The fronts only, of course, I should say, fronts only. Backs don't fit with my TCR spoiler right there. You see that? So I'm just gonna, already told you, I'm gonna clear bra, and I'm gonna work on the antenna in a minute. Did I say clear bra? I meant clay. I'm gonna work on the antenna removal here. I'm gonna start it and just see if I can even do it. I mean, I could also see how you could cut around this, lift the seal with a pick, but that is so sketchy. You're definitely gonna scratch everything. I'm not gonna do that. I have to get the antenna off or it's just a no-go. There's no way I'm gonna try and wrap it under there. Anybody that does it that way is a super cheap shop. So, and they probably scratch the hell out of either your antenna or your roof around it or both. So we'll see how it goes. I think I'll keep the antenna attempts in this video, and then some of the other actual work is gonna be in the second video.
Debe ser alta Rosa y Delgadita.
Lunes, martes, ratones, pez. Miércoles, jueves, todos, todos. Lunes, martes, ratones, pez. Miércoles, jueves.
So we're gonna look at that antenna. We're gonna see what the heck's going on. Now I think I've had this piece off before, this center piece. I'm trying to see. Yeah, it looks like the center definitely comes off, not the sides. The center is over the side pieces, you know what I mean? So I'll probably need two hands and have to come back to you in a minute, but let me just see. Actually, I might remove this. But sometimes when I remove this stiff rubber, I can bend the metal inside accidentally, and it has a curve that you just can't get out. So sometimes I keep that in mind before I rip this off. If it's super stiff, it just won't go on too well. But I very well may have to. It looks like I probably have to just take that off and bite the bullet. I'll get it back on. Let's try that. I am gonna clean that. I wanted to show you how nicely this cleans. Let me spray it a little mother's glory. The glory hole. Woohoo! Look at that dirt. Oh my god, I don't even want to drop that in my freaking car. That is thick. And it does stop right about here, luckily. It doesn't like seem to drip. There's my neighbor again, always honking at me. My buddy, I should say. Get all this crap off, clean it up a little bit. There, it's almost cherry again. So I thought that was like built in, like rust spots and all kinds of stuff, but it would come off with probably no liquid at all, just a freaking cloth. So now that we clean that up, we can continue a little bit. All right, with the badass GoPro light again, let me get this adjusted. So everybody that wants to know, always, nobody ever shows them what really goes on. You got downward clips there. See that? So all I'm doing is kind of going like this. Let's see if it's that easy. Where's the next clip? It might be here. Or, I mean, really you need your hand to work this properly. But that's what you got. You're gonna have little clips. I'll just go ahead and work on popping these out and we'll see where we get. Badass. No clips left in the car. It's exactly what you got. We're getting closer, but this is all the easy stuff. I think I've tried to reach that crap before in there and it's super hard. So let me just take a few investigations here, figure out what's going on, and I'll be back to you here to see if we can get to that antenna. I'm getting deeper into this. So first off, I couldn't move this at all with these things holding it. So next, I'm gonna kinda pop these little sides out here like that, and not a whole lot. You can see my rear. That's probably my rear Blackview cam, I believe, probably right there. Ooh, I can actually route this better. Oh, I didn't take those sides off when I did the cam. I didn't even think of it, and it was all sketch on that ridge. I can tuck it behind now. Killer. Okay, so I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. Then see, the thing is, did you notice the headliner goes way up? So I was peeking right here like, duh, I'm gonna find it. How the hell are you gonna get way over there? I don't know, and I'll very well abandon this project if I feel like it, so I'm gonna keep looking here. Okay, let me show you what we got so far. First off, I'm a little more happy. The antenna's a lot closer to the rear than I was imagining, you know, from way back here. So, why do I have a flashlight? To show you inside. See, I got my two sides down. I can pull down. I haven't even looked up here yet. Whoa, it's right there. Gotta be careful, I'm gonna fucking rip my headliner. Can you see those wires in there? That's it. Holy shit. I think, is that it? Yeah, that is it. It's, oh my God, it's a lot easier than I thought. Of course, I could easily rip my headliner trying to get a bit on that. Now, I even, oh yeah, this will work. And this is all freaking leftover rear cam wire. I'm gonna wrap that all back in there when I'm done. This could happen. Do I have my, no, these aren't my readers. Oh, I have my readers. They magnify like 20%. And then I can like see stuff because I'm old. It looked like a Phillips, but I just can't imagine they'd use a Phillips. So I want to look again. It's fucking hard. Oh, sorry. It's hard to see. Maybe it is a Torx. It's very hard to see. I'm going to probably get some pics and zoom in. This is a whole project. But I will like let you have a gander if I try and attempt it, maybe show you the tool. Okay, guys, so it appears it's a T30. Yeah, I mean, it fit in there. I'll find out to make sure. And this is about the shallowest thing I can get. Now, I could do a freaking open-end wrench over that bit, and I may have to. I'm going to test fit it and see if I can get in here without ripping anything. But I can always put a tiny wrench on that and just do it by feel, too. It's not that hard. I only recently found out my cool yellow light has a tripod hole in it. Pretty cool, huh? I mean, I need it to be brighter, but I really just wanted to show you the sweet wrench. And that I actually am now taking it out. And I'm gonna use two hands and try not to completely destroy this headliner. And we'll see how it goes. Whew, got it, boys and girls. Just about got it loose here. So I'm gonna go ahead and give you all the hands. Oh man. See, it was tripping me out for a while because my ratchet kept flipping backwards without me knowing it. And I was tightening and loosening, and I was afraid there was some nut up inside the mechanism, which was broke loose. And like it maybe was spinning, like, you know, when it gets unwelded from the frame. And I was all, oh shit, am I gonna have this nightmare where that's gonna leak now? But luckily I was just turning the wrong way. It did come out. It is a T30. Let's get a real good look at that, because I just was not sure. It's hard to see it a little bit. Well, in this stupid light. There. Let's get some natural. Natural light is always way the best. Oh, yeah, look at that. So this is your antenna holder here. Okay. I mean, there's no going back now, right? My antenna is off. Let's see. Let's see what happens here. My next question is, and I know the trick to remove the wires because people have posted about it. But I just don't know if I'll do it from top or bottom. Let me see. Probably from... Huh. All right. I mean, maybe you need... Yeah, you probably... Of course, you need to get the wires off because they're like angled out outside of that circle blocking it. So the next thing is the wires. It sucks. The whole thing is here. You got no room. I can't make you a nice light show. It's hard, but I'm telling you what I can as I go. I want to give you another badass tip, which is what I was just talking about, the trick people said. So when they're on the, well, let me fix it here a little bit first. Get it where it should be. I have to fix it later. Whoops. Fix that later. See, when it's normal, it's like this on the antenna, and you can't press in your tab. Yes, I'm going to fix it later, because this is in the way. So everybody's trick is you turn the wire 90 while it's on there, and then you can press that tab. And I gotta fix the one that fell off, nothing's cracked, and do the other two. You were working as a waitress in a cocktail bar. That much is true. But once it ended, I fell with you. Okay, we got our three off. All the tabs came out a little bit, just messing with them, and I just snapped them back in. Like that. I just snapped that one back in. It wasn't in all the way because I don't want to lose them, you know. So I'll just make sure they're all the way down, which they are. Oh, that's, holy shit. Here we go. Uh-oh. What the? What the heck? Let me look again, and then I'm going to have to start Googling to see what the last step is here. Or if I'm not, I don't think I'm not pulling hard enough. Maybe there's a little push pin underneath. Let me check. I almost like broke it. There is some push pins underneath. Woo! Oh, how often do you get to see this? Okay, diamond hole. Color coded. Fuck yeah. These clips here on the sides are what stopped her from coming out. I may have been able to, there wasn't that much wire play. I may have been able to lift it up this way to release, and I would have had a little bit of access, but I don't think there was enough play. Wow. Whew. Wow. Never thought I'd accomplish that job. I need to polish this thing. This thing is destroyed. Oh my God, this thing will look so much better. And no, I'm not gonna mess with the rubber whatsoever. Don't mess with what's not broke. If I try putting a new one on or anything like that, it's definitely gonna leak. I have no problems. I'll torque it nice. I can't believe we got this far. Now there's no going back for that roof wrap. Even for 2 weeks, I'm gonna blue tape the hole if I have to. If this one doesn't work, and if I gotta wait for the next one, obviously I'm not gonna put my antenna back on. A little bit of sneaky peek. Just clean this off. Holy God, this is such a trip. Oh, now I see. Hell yeah, you can get the... I might purposely leave those little marks to help me figure out my vinyl. That's sweet. I thought the vinyl had to be, a huge hole. It's only a tiny, tiny hole that you cut through with the vinyl. That's going to be nothing. Put two razor blade cuts in it and shove the damn antenna through. You're done. Oh my God, that's killer. Man, you guys are going to love this. That's probably a good time to end part one and publish it. Because part two is going to be more crazy. Wow. Oh, I know what I was going to do. Let me just show you now, since this is the real video and more people might be watching it. Let me pop my sunroof and show you the installation plan. Oh, hell yeah. Giovanni's Custom Steering Wheel. Gio_GZ something or other on Instagram. Good luck with that. 500 to 600. Compare that to other freaking expensive wheel prices. This wheel has done me nice. As you can see, I have no issues yet. And I've had this, I don't know, a year at least. A year, probably a year. What I was going to show you here is my plans. So first off, you can see that there's nothing here to get in the way of the wrap. All it's gonna do is fold over. Of course, I'm gonna clean all the edges. And here, super easy again, just fold over the thing. Razor tape here. There's nothing difficult about this wrap job. This, in fact, is one of the most easiest wrap jobs I'll attempt. That's why I'm super worried. If I'm not able to do this, something's wrong. Or if I get unlucky with a piece of dust, you know, that's not all my fault, but this is not that hard a wrap, guys. I'm sure the antenna part is harder than the rest of it. The antenna part's harder than the wrap. Let me see here in this drawer. Where is my tape? Oh my God, a fly just flew out of that secret drawer. He's been in there for months. Razor tape. You familiar with this puppy? Oh, knifeless tape. Knifeless tape, sorry, not razor tape. And this is where we're gonna go down the edges. I'm gonna close this. That's part two. I'm gonna close it and get these perfect lines laid out. And actually, ooh, man, I already washed this. How the hell is there already dust here? I better close that garage real soon and do another wipe down. I gotta get this going. I can't mess around anymore. This thing's gonna be wrecked by the time I'm ready to do it.